Hello students, welcome to my physics class. This is Shumi Roy from Techno India Group Public School, Siliguri. And today we are going to learn a new topic from our chapter Windstorms and Cyclones. In our last class, we have learned that atmosphere exerts a pressure called atmospheric pressure due to the weight of air containing it. We have also learned some properties of air, that is, air exerts pressure and air expands on heating. Today, in our class, we will discuss how wind is produced. Wind is the movement of air, which depends on the difference in air pressure or atmospheric pressure in the two regions. Air moves from the region of high air pressure to region of low air pressure in the atmosphere. The greater the difference in the air pressure, the faster the air moves. Thus, the speed of the wind depends on the difference in the air pressure between the two regions. The greater the difference in the air pressure between two regions, the faster the wind blows. Wind currents are generated due to the uneven heating on the earth. This uneven heating are due to the two situations. They are uneven heating between the equator and the poles and uneven heating on land and water. Now, let us discuss how wind is produced by the uneven heating between equator and poles of Earth. The region close to the equator of Earth gets the maximum heat from the sun. So, the air in the equatorial region gets heated and becomes warm. The warm air rises in the equatorial region of the earth, creating an area of low air pressure. The cooler air from the region of up to 30 degree latitude belt on both the sides of the equator rushes towards the equator to take the place of warm rising air. This makes the wind to blow from north and south direction towards the equator, as shown in figure. These winds also blow from north and south direction towards the warmer latitude region. Again, the air at latitudes of about 60 degrees on both the sides of the equator is warmer than at the poles, which is very cold. So, the warmer air at about 60 degree latitude rises up, creating region of low air pressure. And cold air from the polar region, being at higher pressure, rushes in to take the place. This makes the wind blow from the poles of the earth towards a warmer region up to about 60 degree latitudes. The cold wind from the polar region rushes in to take its place. In this way, wind circulation is set up from the poles to the warmer latitudes. The wind would have flown in the north-south direction from north to south or from south to north. A change in the direction is, however, caused by the rotation of the earth. The wind produced by the uneven heating of the earth between the equator and the poles do not blow in exact north-south direction because a change in the direction of wind is caused by the rotation of the earth on its axis. Now, let us discuss how wind is produced by the uneven heating of land and water in oceans. During summer, land near the equator of Earth heats up faster than the water in oceans. So, most of the time, the temperature of land is higher than that of water in oceans. The air over the land gets heated and rises, creating a low pressure area. The cooler air from over the oceans, being at higher pressure, rushes towards the land, This causes the wind to blow from ocean towards the land. The winds blowing from the ocean towards the land in summer are called monsoon wind. The monsoon wind carry a lot of water from the oceans in the form of water vapor and bring large amount of rain on land. The process in which the winds coming from the oceans carry a lot of water vapor and bring rain is a part of the water cycle in nature. In India, the land, especially the Rajasthan desert, gets heated much more in summer than the water in the Indian Ocean. This uneven heating of land and water in Indian Ocean during summer generates monsoon wind from the Indian Ocean. The monsoon wind coming from the southwest direction in summer carry a lot of water vapor from the Indian Ocean and bring heavy rains, known as monsoon or rainy season. The summer monsoon is very important to the farmers in our country because most of the annual rainfall occurs at this time and helps in growing crops. Many farmers in our country depends mainly on rains for the irrigation of their crops. We have learned that during summer, wind blows from the ocean towards land. In winter, the direction of wind flows get reversed. During winter, wind blows from the land towards the ocean. During winter, land cools down faster than the water in ocean. So the temperature of water in oceans is higher than that of land. The warm air over the ocean rises up, creating a region of low pressure, and cooler air from the land rushes towards the ocean. This causes wind to blow from land towards the ocean. The winds coming from the colder land region carry only a little of water vapor and hence bring only a small amount of rain in winter season. In India, the land, especially the northwest region, gets cooled much more in winter than the water in Indian Ocean. This uneven heating of land and water in Indian Ocean during winter generates wind from the northwest colder land going towards the Indian Ocean. The colder winds coming from the northwest direction in wind carry only a small amount of water vapor and hence bring only a small amount of rain in winter season. I hope you all have understood how wind is produced due to uneven heating of earth by the sun. In our next class, we will discuss how cyclones, tornadoes, and thunderstorms are formed. We will also discuss about precautions to be taken during a thunderstorm. We will discuss some of the destruction caused by cyclones. And we will discuss about advanced technology that has helped in protection from cyclones. Thank you for joining the class.